Hi guys, so I'm back with MSI's GL62M, which is a budget gaming laptop that I picked up for about $899 US. So it had a really good price to it, and in my review, if you've seen it, you would have noticed that thermals just got way too hot. I mean, it got up to 96 degrees with thermal throttling, and it also ran into some issues with performance because of this, playing some titles like Battlefield 1, that it would cause these huge frame dips. And that was not ideal at all. Terrible, really. So I blamed in my review the performance of those coolers they put in there. So the two fans I thought were probably just too small and it could not expel that heat fast enough or get a good enough flow going through. Turns out I was wrong here. It was in fact the thermal paste that they used on this. So they haven't used a high quality one. I repasted it and I put some Arctic MX2 on here. Now I used the baggy method, which is basically sticking a finger into a plastic bag and using that to spread a very even thin layer of thermal paste on both the die for the CPU and the GPU, so I repasted both of them there, and it's made a huge difference now to thermals, increased their performance as well, and we'll take a look at that. So I'm going to retest one game here, which was Battlefield 1, the one that really ran into the problems, and see if that's now fixed. We'll take a look at the temperatures again, compare them to the previous temperatures I was getting in my review, and also do further overclocking of that GPU. So if you're not familiar with the spec of this laptop here, it has an i7-7700HQ, and that's quite a typical one you will find in gaming laptops, and the performance of that CPU is quite good. But of course it got up to 96 degrees, 93 in my review. That was causing a lot of thermal throttling. And it did end up causing these frame rate dips, for example, in Battlefield. But you can see now it's just so much smoother here, and performance is really a lot better because it was dipping down to about 20 frames per second. And here you can see it is very steady now, keeping well above 100 there, which is a really good performance from the 1050 Ti. Now, the current settings I'm running this game on are, it is 1080p, but on the lowest settings, that for me seemed to be the fastest that I was going to get. Now thermals, that's what has really improved here. Maximum of, yeah, the warden isn't going to last too long. Of 80 degrees here, you can see. Hang on, that was the GPU, 65. Show you that in a second. So 80 degrees after 20 minutes of gaming. This on the stock thermal job that they did, the thermal paste job they did there, would have been about 95 degrees, 96 degrees. So that's a huge improvement of approximately 15 degrees less to the maximum temperatures due to my repaste here that I did using Arctic's MX-2 thermal compound, which, you know, isn't a top thermal compound. It's quite a cheap one too. And then 65 degrees maximum on the GPU. So because of those lower temperatures, I also added a higher clock to my Nvidia 1050 Ti here, a whopping 290 to the core clock megahertz, which is quite a lot there, and then 1 GB to the RAM, which is why I'm getting that improved performance there. And I did retest Firestrike, so I got a higher score there, nearing up and edging towards the 8000 area, which is where the Nvidia 1060, the Max-Q lies, similar kind of scores there, so that's not bad at all considering. So overall, now with my thermal paste changed, lower temperatures, I'm actually enjoying this laptop because we're not getting those spikes anymore. It just goes to show you that MSI's factory, they are putting on way too much thermal paste, and I do recommend that you redo it if you're going to be buying this laptop or even any other budget gaming laptop, that you redo the thermal paste there. Thanks a lot for watching this video, and I do hope to see you back in the channel soon.